Before I say something else, just watch this.
तो आप में से कोई मुझे बता सकता है ये क्या है?
सर,
यस
सर, गांड है सर.
वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. बट किसकी? दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. यस
सर, आपकी.
नाइस. और कौन इसे चाटेगा? बट क्यों?
दैट्स फनी
सर.
यस,
क्योंकि आप हमारे ट्रेनिंग एंड प्लेसमेंट ऑफिसर हो और आप ही इस कॉलेज में कंपनीज लेके आते हो.
वेरी गुड, रियली गुड.
थैंक यू सर.
अब तक तो आपको क्रोनोलॉजी समझ में आ ही गया होगा कि हम वीडियो में क्या बोलने वाले हैं. तो अगर आपको अपनी ऐसी मरवानी नहीं है तो आगे देखते रहिए. यू माइट हैव रियली अंडरस्टूड व्हाट द क्रोनोलॉजी ऑफ दिस वीडियो इज गोना बी ऑल अबाउट. यू रियली हैव अंडरस्टूड व्हाट दिस वीडियो इज गोना ऑल अबाउट. सो माय चैनल इज स्पेशली रियली फोकस्ड ऑन द सॉफ्टवेयर डेवलपमेंट और वेब डेवलपमेंट इन जनरल. एंड आई एम रियली फोकस्ड ऑन टू रियली मेकिंग द वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल्स ऑन जावास्क्रिप्ट, AWS, and really my channel is mostly categorized into two subtopics, like making the face mash and the dev talk itself. But sometimes it really makes sense to really make a video just like this one, to really just kind of deep dive into some of the realities that and the problems that we are facing in a society, and to really just kind of express my thought about what are the solution, prominent solution regarding to this, and what can you really just go on and try to do it out. So on the one other hand, you might have really heard just like there is XYZ percent of unemployment, but on the other hand, you really look up to site like LinkedIn, which is professional, which is a social network site for the professionals people out there. You really see that there are crazy amount of job, even thousands of job in Pune itself. So what's actually going wrong? On the other hand, we are really looking that people are more and more people are getting unemployed day by day, and on the other hand, you are really looking, you are really seeing that on the job profile portals like LinkedIn and Indeed, etc., that there are a hell lot of job opportunities. So there is some sort of a mismatch out there. So, and I really want to really just kind of emphasize that how you can get a high paying job and what's the actual right recipe for getting a high paying job, and what do you really mean by high paying job itself. So first you really need to understand that if I really have a 100 rupees note with me, what do this 100 rupees note really mean about? So if I really do a work for someone else, I have really created a value for them that in exchange of that value, that person has really offered me a 100 rupees note or any other currency or any other dollar, euros, pound, yen, whatever you like. Number one. So, and you can think of it as like a, let's suppose you are a company itself. You are like any software company like Google, Facebook, Netflix, Amazon, Twitter, Tinder, anything else. And you have a crazy amount of money with you. So what you will naturally really try to do is you will really want best of the best engineer with you, right? So now really come back to the reality. So every year, lakhs of engineers out there are really graduating on really an enormous scale. So you really have to really ask yourself that what really makes you stand out of those lakhs of engineers out there, number one. And why people are really so unemployed, why even after existing so many job opportunities, people are not fulfilled with their life. People are not really kind of getting what they want. People are not really fulfilled to really live up to their desires. So a part of number one is like, our education system is so damn corrupt. It's so fatal, it's so flawed. But you know, instead of really bashing the system out there, it's like I really want to focus, I really want to talk about what as we on individual can we do on our personal level. So once you have completed your 12th standard or high school, and once you have and after entering in an engineering college or your engineering career, So what will you do in these 4 or 5 years, depending upon it? So coming back to the 100 rupees example, by the way, as I really mentioned about what is really mean by to earn 100 rupees in exchange of some amount of value out there. So if you really want a high paying job, so what is essentially the high paying job itself really mean that you are getting a hefty amount of money in exchange of creating a value to outs value out in exchange of creating a value in a marketplace. So how will you create a value in marketplace? So let's suppose I will take the example of software engineering. As we really know that the education system is quite really old-fashioned manner. Everything is of old thing. Everything is just taught in a such a book that in a such a textbooks that really it's our that really gets outdated in every 6 months out there. So what essentially you really need to do is like, so currently you need to ask yourself that why are you doing engineering? So because I firmly believe that the 60% of the student that really does engineering, they don't have any particular interest in doing engineering. They just want a really good lifestyle, just want to really earn money, to really fulfill their own desires and out there, which is fine. Considering, not saying that the engineering is a bad field or any some sort of thing, but you really have to genuinely ask yourself whether what are you trying to do? And this is something a really philosophical question out there, which Sandeep Maheshwari has really discussed in hell lot of deep down in detail. You can just really search on YouTube itself, what you will get a crazy amount of results out there. Suppose you really want a high paying job, let's suppose 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 3 lakh rupees per month or something like that. So first question you really need to ask that why the HR would really give you that kind of money. And let's suppose that HR is really giving you that kind of money itself, that means you are really that valuable. You are really providing that value to them out there. That is really helping to really solve their crucial problems out there. That is really helping out there to really fix and to really just heal their pain points out there. Coming back to this value proposition and value addition point. Now, how will you create the value? That is really fundamental question. There are really a lot of ways to create values out there, right? So you really need to ask yourself, like, what really excites you the most? What is the key thing that you really do in order to really that will really keep you motivated itself continuously? What is something that will really push yourself even when you're not feeling to work? And suppose you have really interest in computer itself, start figuring out the trends, like what are the people really looking like. The key reason why the education system is outdated and why the industry is really different and why there is such a demand and supply gap, because the college is teaching something else, and the interviewer or that company requires a different level of skill set, which is not really matching anything, which is not matching at all. And that really creates some sort of a chaotic situation or a crisis where you can really take the advantage of it, or you can just cry it out. So what do you really need to think of it is like, suppose you have a kind of you have taken a CS job, sorry, you have taken a kind of CS curriculum out there. So you really need to study about what is the thing. So there are really many things in the CS itself, like web development, Android, iOS, blockchain, machine learning, AI, desktop application, mobile application, like building programming languages. There are multiple things that you can really do. Similarly with the mechanical engineering, same with the chemical also, same with the anything out there, depending upon the various opportunity aspect that you really kind of get to explore yourself. So after really knowing all these things about what are the really crucial steps that the market is demanding, you really need to figure out what is your core aspect, what is the core values, and what is the core belief. and what really interests you the most. And after really choosing these two of these, you can really pick a specific stack of technology that you really need to learn itself. Suppose if you want to be a web developer itself, you really need to study like what it really takes to become a web developer, what it really takes to become a mobile developer, what it really takes to become a mechanical engineer, what it really takes to really like to crack it in XYZ company itself. And after really asking like if you and after really asking like yourself the question like what you want to be and what you want to learn, if these two things are really clear to yourself, spend a considerable amount of time in mastering that. Now, why that mastering is really essential for you? Because that mastering is only the one thing that is such a important thing is now in today's date. Because on the other side, there is really like a demand and supply gap. And the majority of people are really getting failed due to their impotency or due to their lack of inability or due to their lack of skills that is really required to really work in that those companies out there. So if you have those skills, naturally what you will really like, you will rise above them. And rising above is just only the one stage. But what happened and by becoming a master of it is like you will just shine in the eyes of that company itself. Like this is the guy, this is the particular person that we really want to solve our problem. So if you really spend a considerable amount of time, let's suppose if I really want to become a web developer, I really spend a 1 year into it and I really know everything of it, like making the UI, making the backend, deploying and everything out there. So naturally what I will really essentially is like the level of my knowledge will be much more higher or much more superior to rest of all other thousands of students out there who really don't know this kind of thing. And even if I really go to the interviewer and really say that, hey, I have really worked to this problem and I have really worked on to this challenge out there, and he will really notice the difference instantaneously. That will really differentiate you between those thousands of students out there and as an individual, as a person, you will have that really power to really just kind of please or really charm the interviewer out itself. So I just really wanted to focus like being a you really need to consider master itself, because in this today's era where we are really kind of addicted to instant gratification, we are really kind of addicted to this that dopamine spike itself. We really need something that is truly meaningful out there. People are not really willingly investing their time itself to mastering a particular skills or mastering a particular trait. And because of it, they really compromise the job they get. They really tend to short sell themselves. They are not generally happy with what they have got. And you really kind of fall into that trap. So if you really want a high paying job, find what your interests are, find what you are really passionate about doing else, pick a certain skill, spend a dedicated amount of time in mastering it, and really just kind of search for it, number one, and have the ability to sell yourself. In the transactional world in today's day, there is only two things: either you are selling something or you are being getting sold, right? So with this topic, I just want to end my few words on this view that how to get a high paying job itself. And becoming a master in something else, becoming a master in some particular traits that you really like, is the only one way that you can really just crack that view out there. This was it, guys. I just wanted to emphasize what are the really just kind of few things out there. So if you have any question, queries, comments, suggestions out there, so just leave down in the comment section and I'll be really happy to get back to you. So if you have not subscribed to this channel, make sure to subscribe it. And I'll be really making a video especially on IIT itself about, and the JE results are really going to be getting soon out itself. So make sure to share this video on every other platform also itself. So till then, stay connected and have a good day.